Welcome to the Football Parliament podcast, your one-stop destination for all your football debates, discussions and opinions. Today I'm joined with Anshiraj and Manish. We will be talking about the post-Messi era, which has already started with Barcelona under Ronald Koeman. So Anshiraj, starting off with the previous season, what exactly went wrong and what exactly went right?
I think the La Liga and Champions League experience was kind of disappointing, especially after showing promise, especially in La Liga during the mid-season, because we started quite poorly, and then at the end of season again we started to play poorly again. So we ultimately finished third, and then in the Champions League the group stage was promising for the first five games, and the sixth and seventh game against Juventus and PSG we got completely outclassed. In the second leg, however, we were pretty good, and in fact, in my opinion, we were the better team. So yeah. But we still lost the match. So I think there's some improvement to be made there.
Yeah, I think going by the second half of the season, which Barcelona had, there was quite a good amount of progress, because you all went from 12th to 3rd. That's fine. And in Champions League, a club like Barcelona is usually expected to go to these quarterfinals or semifinals. And Barcelona got eliminated in round of 16. That was the review for the previous season, going towards the departures and arrivals of this season. Manish, let's specifically talk about the arrivals which Barcelona made this season.
The arrivals, one of the main ones being Memphis Depay, and the departures, the main one being Lionel Messi. So what I think is that the hole left by Lionel Messi of scoring as well as creating can be filled in by Memphis Depay, because he's a Messi type, I will not call him a Messi type player, but he has the qualities which can help Barcelona fulfill that gap. So he's a really good creator and he's a very good goal scorer as well. So yeah, and Aguero, well, now he's picked up an injury, but he's a signing. If he's fit, when he's on his day, he's a really good player, but then injury has always been an issue. And even Emerson, he'll fight with Dest for the right back spot constantly. So that'll be that.
For some reason, I feel that he's going to overtake Dest and be Barcelona's right back in the future, near future. Going towards the team, the formation, how this team would line up. Anshiraj, I would like you to present the 3-5-2, which we discussed. As Anshiraj shows in his 3-5-2 formation, or rather I should say FPP's 3-5-2 formation, Manish, I would like to discuss with you the weaknesses and the strengths of this Barcelona team in 21-22 season.
See, now the defense is a little bit shaky. Like, there are players like Araujo, they're really good, like Araujo, Mingueza, Eric Garcia. But then there are players like Longley who are error prone, who give away cheap penalties and all that. So you cannot fully rely on the defense at Barcelona. So that's what I think.
Manish, after Messi's departure, who do you think will be the leader in Barcelona?
I think Busquets or Piqué.
But the thing with Piqué is that we don't feel Piqué is going to get as many games as he used to. Because firstly, being his age, his physique, and his lack of defensive movement as of now.
Yeah, that's a fair point there. Hello. Yeah. Oh, he will probably only play for his experience. Okay,
yeah,
so now
only the big games he'll be used.
Yeah, maybe. So I'm going to now present the
screen share.
Yeah. So this is the 3-5-2 which Koeman used in the second half of the season. And if he continues to use this in the upcoming season as well, I think this is most probably how we'll line up. Ter Stegen in goal, definitely. Araujo will probably start, because he's sort of really impressed during preseason and during last season as well. In this exact same formation, he was also pretty good. Eric Garcia, new signing, and he's like this typical Barcelona center back, pass well, and is good on the ball. And he's also got a decent amount of pace on him. So, he can cover up for like other defenders, and especially Longley, who's pretty error prone in itself. Then the left side of the defense, you'll have Longley. I think he'll probably only start because he's a left-footed center back. You know, because of his left-footedness, he can play those passes towards Alba, and he can also play those incisive passes as well. Wing backs. Jordi Alba will probably start without any real competition, and because there's not really any other left backs at the club. Emerson might give him a little bit of competition, but he's primarily being brought as right back, and that is, I think, where he'll play if he plays. At the right wing back position, Dest and Emerson will fight it out for it. I think there's a 50-50 chance that either of them will start, and they're both pretty similar players to each other. You know, they like to bomb ahead, and they can also defend pretty well. Then the midfield is the most assured part of the team, in my opinion. This is where I think these three will definitely start. De Jong, the progressor, Busquets, the conductor, Pedri are sort of like, you know, our new Iniesta, as we call him. Then we'll come to the front two. Manish, what do you think? Are these two the ones who will start, or will Fati and Aguero also play roles in this two?
No, I think Depay and Griezmann would constantly start, and Griezmann can fully focus on his goal scoring now that he's somewhat relieved of the creative duties which he had last season, somewhat the ones which he had. So, and Depay, he'll score as well as create. I guess Griezmann will score around 20 goals in all competitions for Barcelona this season.
Okay. I think Koeman might also use a 4-3-3. He's sort of tended to show that in the preseason, but I think this is what he will mainly stick to. He'll stick to his newfound
be at the back
in the
3-4. I think looking at this team, what I feel is that defense will still be the issue for Barcelona for another season, because they're going for Arau. He's a good center back, but again, he's a bit inexperienced, should I say? Or anyways, not even talking about him, going towards Lenglet. He's the weak, I should say, the weak link in the team. And apart from that, Garcia, who last season barely got any minutes. He is a youth prospect, but again, he's too young to have that main centre-back role, like the middle centre-back.
We might see PK feature here sometimes, but I am generally not in favour of PK starting anymore. I think he's past it. I think we should favour these guys instead. Mingueza could also feature in this back three.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, I think Oscar Mingueza is a great prospect. I think he has a chance of making this lineup. Going towards the key positions, what do you feel, Ansharaj, the key positions for this team are?
Key positions, because we generally can't defend. So I think it'll have to be the attack. The attack will have to carry the team, and they'll have to outscore the opponent at whatever cost. Depay and Griezmann, if Fati and Aguero start, they'll all have to be firing on all cylinders at all times. There cannot be any slack performances from them, because you know the lack of defensive stability is pretty concerning for us. So I think the attack will be pretty important. The midfield again is the heartbeat of the team. You know, without those three, I don't think we can really put up any challenge for any titles, I think. So the midfield and the attack.
In the middle of the park, they've got the experience and the leader, Sergio Busquets. So I feel the communication won't be a problem in the team when they're on the pitch. Apart from that, talking about another player, Ansu Fati, do you see him stepping up now that Messi's gone too?
He will be able to get a decent amount of game time this season, because there's one less spot to be contended for, because Messi has left. So if he gets that consistent run of games, you might see him replicate that form at the start last season, where he won Player of the Month in La Liga, and he scored like 6 goals in that month itself.
He was the top scorer for a while, but then he got injured.
Yeah, then he got injured, and he's returned to training pretty recently. So. I think if he gets that consistent run of games, if he can replicate that form, he can definitely displace one of the big two, that is Griezmann and Depay.
Manish, who do you think gets the next number 10?
Number 10. I don't think they'll give it to anyone. I guess Depay. Yeah.
Okay, and who gets the number 9?
Number nine. I think Depay is a perfect fit at number 9.
Yes, of course. Yes.
Okay. Now, talking about another player, a number 10, not of Barcelona, but a natural number 10, Felipe Coutinho. Anshiraj, what is exactly going to happen with him?
I don't know, honestly. If one of our midfielders picks up an injury, I think we'll have to rely on him for some part. But the thing is, Coutinho is like this sort of outlier in that midfield. He doesn't really run a lot, you know, because Pedri and Frenkie are pretty good runners. They cover huge amounts of the ground. And they, you know, are like the most active pressers. Something which Coutinho doesn't really offer.
Unbelievable.
Yeah, their work rate is pretty good. Something which Coutinho doesn't offer. Yes, he can offer that creativity from deep. But I think for Barcelona, balance is more essential rather than, you know, that flair player right now. Coutinho could be like this, you know, like a super sub if he can come on and just make something out of nothing. But for him to regularly start, it's something which I don't really see Koeman doing. Unless one of our midfielders does get injured.
Okay. Manish, as a rival fan, what do you think about Barcelona's this season? I mean, what are your season expectations from the team?
When Messi first left, I did not see any of their games, any of the preseason games. So I thought that, like last season, we saw how dependent they were on Messi. Like the games which Messi did not play, they were awful. So I thought that they will be nowhere near title contenders. But then I watched the preseason against Juventus and they were pretty impressive. So I think they can put up a fight for it if their defense does not let them down. And I'll go for a bold prediction. I think they'll finish second.
What about in the trophies this season?
Think they'll win their favorite trophy, the Copa del Rey again.
Okay. And Anshiraj, what do you feel about the Champions League? Going further in the round of 16 or still there?
We definitely have the tools to reach, go beyond the round of 16. If we get a relatively easy draw in the first knockout stage, that is the round of 16, we definitely can make it there. But to get that easy draw, I think we need to top our group first. And there's quite a lot of rumors that, you know, the groups this time would be quite tough because, you know, a lot of the big teams are in one pot because, you know, like, you know, your Liverpools and Barcelona, the Real Madrid, they all are in one pot. So you might see a difficult group.
Yeah.
So I think for Barcelona to top that group is essential. And if we want to make it deep into the quarterfinals, but then again, the Champions League is a knockout style tournament. So a lot of it depends on the draws and the luck we face during the key moments. So I think a quarterfinal finish is pretty realistic. But if luck is on our side, we might see a pretty deep run into the tournament.
For me, I can't really predict much. But what I feel is that Memphis Depay and Antoine Griezmann are going to be really very important and key players for Barcelona. And they'll form a great duo. That's what I can say about this team as of now. That is the video for today, guys. I hope you liked it. Keep on commenting. Keep on liking our video. Share. Subscribe to our channel. And we'll see you soon.